All right. What you doing there, Pastor
Meredith?
Oh, my goodness,
see you up there. Well, I've been pouring through my seed catalog, and gosh, there are such beautiful flowers. And, you know, I thought I would plant a garden outside the church for all the people to enjoy as they went by. It has so many good things in here.
That sounds like a good idea.
I'm so sick of the weather.
Yeah, but you're the
I
one who says...
I thought I would get started. It was warm today.
Yeah, but you're the one who says, we're not in Boston.
Yeah, I do say that a lot, don't I?
Yeah, you realize you can't start now.
Why can't I? It was warm. It was almost balmy today.
Come on, one obvious problem.
What's that? Look at these seeds. They're so nice.
The ground.
The ground?
Yeah.
Well,
isn't it a little frozen yet?
Well, I thought I could warm up the shovel and try to dig deep. I thought that would help. And, you know, these are really sharp utensils, garden tools I got here. So I thought maybe I could work it, you know? I mean, I think I could.
Because
I'm really anxious to get out in that soil.
But how are you going to keep the seeds warm?
Well, how about positive thinking? You know, I really want to get things organized and kind of hurry on this season that we're in right now. You know?
You know, I don't think that's going to work. As good as the meteorologists are, they can't change the seasons either.
Well, I guess I'm going to have to be more patient for the changing of the seasons. But it's so hard to wait.
But you remember what the scripture says. For everything there is a season.
And those seasons can be very frustrating sometimes. Let's pray. Lord, help us this Lenten season to turn to you, to turn again and again, and help us to walk through the seasons of our life, knowing that you walk with us. May the words of my mouth and meditation of each of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 is it is the most well-known passage of Ecclesiastes. Pretty much probably the only passage that people know from Ecclesiastes. And it became very popular from Pete Seeger's song that was written in 1954 and has been utilized many other times. That was sung by the Byrds, but it has had other groups that have sung it as well. The Old Testament book of Ecclesiastes offers an honest reflection on the human quest for meaning regarding the realities of life on this earth under God. The point that the writer says is that there is a time for everything. Someone mentioned last night in our Bible study when we took a quick look at Ecclesiastes about that there's a certain order of things in life. In the scripture of Ecclesiastes, the writer is referenced as the teacher. So the teacher says that develops this idea of balancing life in chapter 3. Very descriptive of how life unfolds. Farmers know, better than I, that there is a time for planting and a time for harvest. Then verse 3 appears that, yes, even in this human life, there is a time for war but a time for peace. And there are those times when there is happiness, but also tears to mark our human lives. The book of Proverbs, as well as the book of Ecclesiastes, is part of what we call wisdom literature in the Bible. And there's a couple of references in those books about when to speak and when to be silent. But, you know, there's something that runs through the book of Ecclesiastes that sometimes runs through our life as well, and that is we want to be in control, right? We want to be in control of those seasons. We want to be making the decisions of when this stuff happens. And we hear in the scripture that we don't. We don't. Even our best laid plans can go awry at times. Just ask a mother who's given birth on the way to the hospital. Or as I was sharing with Tiffany today, everything's all laid out and then boom, some medical issue. Or I had a member in my last congregation who she didn't actually graduate from hospice, but she certainly outlived the hospice plan, far outlived the hospice plan. So we do not have control over these kinds of things. Chapter 3 continues with this verse, "I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He's made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he's put a sense of the past and future into their minds, yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end." So God places within us the past and the future, but we can't know it all because we're not God. We're just human. Ecclesiastes reminds us that there are many things in this life that we do not have control over. The teacher writes, "In addition to not worrying, which is hard for some of us, about things that we can't control, we should enjoy the gifts that God has given us, and we should stand, and I quote, before God in awe, whose mighty acts, nothing can be added or taken away." So the writer says, you know, we can't worry about things that are not in our control. And in the meantime, we are to enjoy the gifts that God has given us. And we should stand before God in awe. Now, Ecclesiastes talks a lot about God's timing, which is different than predestination. As Lutherans, we don't believe in predestination. Predestination being that somehow your life has been predestined from birth. It is all laid out. There is nothing that you can do to make that change. It is like on a railroad track, you're on a train on a railroad track, and you're going down that path, and nothing's going to change it. Predestination is not what we believe. We believe that our decisions and our actions and all those things affect our life and how we live. And that it's not predestined that I do this or I do that. I think that's important to recall that God is not in control in that kind of way. But it does refer to God's timing. Ecclesiastes says that there's a time for every purpose under heaven. A time to plant, a time to gather into harvest, a time to laugh, a time to cry, a time to quiet, a time to speak up. Now, some of these things, when they have these 14 comparatives, are not easy. It's not easy to cry. It's not easy to grieve. And life is not easy. And it is important to know as we face those seasons of life that we don't face them alone. That indeed our God, who we stand in awe of all what he has done, walks with us. There are times to be with friends, but there's times when we need to be alone. And of course we like to have fun, but sometimes we feel sad. Things hurt us. Or we have friends that are hurting and we feel sad. And we need to acknowledge those feelings. And in the seasons of things like summer when we can swim and enjoy baseball and play golf, we also need to know that we have this season called winter. The purpose of winter being that we appreciate summer, right? Okay. One of my classmates from seminary, Pastor Janet Hunt, has written this. She said, how do these words from Ecclesiastes apply to my life? So let's think about that. What does it mean to be born to new life or to die with family members, friends, neighbors, and coworkers? Could it mean that that we can share in their joys, life, and we can share in their sufferings, their mourning, death? Or what might it mean to plant or harvest in the daily tasks that we do? How do you plant in your daily life, in your work? How do you plant new ideas, new agendas, new projects? How do you harvest them? You parents are planting and harvesting in your children all the time. What does it mean that there is a time of mourning, but to remember may take a while, a long while? But there will be a time of dancing once more. Or when I'm laughing and others are grieving so much that they can't even remember the sound of joy anymore. How much would people benefit from me just keeping my silence sometimes? Are there times, though, when my voice needs to be used to encourage and express hope when it is desperately needed? How do I understand this time for war? What does it mean? And what does peace look like in our world? So there are these opportunities for reflection and the reminder that it is God who holds us as we walk through all those seasons. For life is made up of seasons. And part of those seasons of life is to make us more mature people, to move beyond just kind of the simple answers of life, but to get some depth and experience and wisdom. When you ripen fruit too quickly, it loses its flavor. These days, fruit or vegetables are picked before they ripen on the vine. They're picked, say, for a tomato when it's green, it's shipped out, and then through some artificial means, they can make it red, and they hurry the process so that in the dead of winter, when you go to the grocery store, you go to buy a tomato. It looks like a tomato, but it doesn't taste like a tomato, right? We can't hurry the seasons. So usually there are no shortcuts to maturity. Although I know some of you young people have had that maturity compressed in your life, for you have had to face many issues, or perhaps friends, or you adults when you were younger, that you had to face so many of these seasons at such a young age, that maturity happened very early. So this word of Ecclesiastes about the seasons of life, he reminds us that we are to appreciate the simple things of life, things like loving work, one's family, the food that you're able to enjoy, finding value in ordinary things of life. Not just striving for the glitz or the glam or the big trips or some of those things, but taking delight in the ordinary of life. In chapter 2, we hear there's nothing better for mortals than to eat and drink and find enjoyment in their toil. I saw that this was from the hand of God, for apart from him, who can eat or who can have enjoyment? So the other thing is to remind us in the midst of the simple things of life, the God who walks with us through these seasons, the God who provides for us, the God who sent his son Jesus to be for us. So may you, through the seasons of life, through the ups and downs, the sunsets and sunrises, the joys and the sorrows, may it be wrapped all in a God who is awesome, a God who loves, a God who forgives, and a God who walks with us. Amen.